I have Simon Shepherd in the studio with me. Simon Shepherd is an artist and he is based in Brighton. Welcome, Simon.
Thank you.
You know, I've been trying to think how to introduce you, what type of artist, and I found that difficult because I know your art, I've seen your art, you're very prolific, but also you cross various genres. It's a little bit of pop art, a little bit of street art, a little bit, you know, sculpture, all sorts of things. Maybe you do the hard work for me and define your art.
Well, you're right, it does cross boundaries and genres. I would say that almost all of it is 3D sculptural work. So that is one thing that you could say about my work. But I don't like to be defined too much in terms of genre, and I like to use different materials and always look to make newer things with new ideas and sometimes new material.
Right, and talking about materials, I attended one of your exhibitions a couple of years ago in Brighton, and I had to go very close and do a double take with some of the works of art because they were so realistic. I just nearly didn't believe you that, you know, that some of them were made of clay. There was, and we'll show some of these on the screen, there was this basketball within a conker. I couldn't believe that it wasn't a real basketball, but it wasn't. And other things. And they all have kind of, whether intentional or not, some messages. Shall we talk about that basketball, for example? First of all, the name of the piece of work.
So the piece is called Divide and Conquer.
Right. Conquer spelt as in
C-O-N-K-E-R. Yes, exactly. And I do like to use humour sometimes in the title or even in the work. It came about because I was thinking about, first of all, I loved that classic design of the basketball. I'm not a basketball player or fan, but it was something about the shape and the design with the different textures and colours that appealed to me. So I wanted to make some work around that design and that object.
Right.
And through almost play, if you like, it came together. I wanted to use something that was man-made, like the basketball, but to combine it with something from the natural world that complemented it or juxtaposed with it. And the thing I used in the end was a conker shell because it made the basketball look like the conker.
The inside of the conker. And I mean, do you, you know how it is, sometimes you look at a work of art and you interpret it, and whether the artist actually meant it or not, a bit like in poetry, is more or less irrelevant if you see something in it. But do you mean to convey, within that slight humour context, some deeper messages? I mean, there is the Coca-Cola cans that are shaped as a cross. What did you mean there, for example?
That piece is probably a more obvious one in terms of meaning, because I'd been thinking about the way in which many people today almost worship the idea of brand, material goods, if you like. And the epitome of that for me was Coca-Cola, the way they brand and market themselves. So it seemed to me that they were almost worshipping, or
right,
people do worship brands, and I used the Coca-Cola can in the form of a cross to combine those ideas.
So you gave it a religious context, which is slightly controversial.
That's okay. I don't mind that.
Right. Right. And then, of course, there are the hands, little children's hands, which is a little bit of a disturbing piece of art, I thought, all kind of confined into a box.
It surprises me when people are disturbed by my art,
really?
But again, I don't perhaps necessarily mind that much.
Right.
I wanted to take a shape that was quite, a shape that was familiar, but quite, the shape of a hand is quite hard to describe. It's not square or round or whatever, but by putting enough of them together in a confined space, then that brought another level of aestheticism to the work.
Right.
It was something quite natural, quite artificial shape, if
right,
you like. So it was playing with that idea.
Okay. So really, if I did try to find some kind of theme, as I said, you have such a variety of ways. You take familiar objects and you kind of deconstruct them. You put them in a slightly unfamiliar, odd context.
Yes, you're right.
That's
an underlying theme in the work.
Okay.
Yeah.
And talking about that, you've got something to show?
I did bring something along today.
Go on.
Okay. So, a new piece of work.
Maybe if you try to show it to the camera.
Okay, I don't know if the camera picks it up, but
that's the map of
it's the British Isles,
mm-hmm,
but it's made up of this wood chip wallpaper. And I was thinking about the idea of randomly tearing away paper from a wall, if you like, stripping wallpaper away, and being left with shapes which we then see meaning in, or try to find meaning in.
Right.
and a very sort of random shape, which is also very familiar to us, I thought was the British Isles.
So it's like an old wall.
This represents
with
an old wall
being
with
apart.
Paper being old wallpaper being ripped off, and something being left behind.
Right.
In this case, the.
So I'm sure there could be layers and layers of interpretations, especially with Brexit, et cetera, et cetera. We won't go into it. So, Simon, I know you're involved with various projects and various exhibitions. How can people look you up and find out what you do, what you're up to?
I find that Instagram is an immediate way for me to upload work that I'm working on currently, show people what I'm doing. So if you are on Instagram and you look on Instagram, it's Simon Shepherd Art, and you'll see my work there. And I try to post, not too much, but new work and significant work when it comes along.
Lovely. Simon, thank you so much for coming.
You're welcome. Thank you.